gutters leaked like secrets, and the rained like rain at Rawlinson End. In the library, a log fire spat tracer over doomed Dresden, and Sir Henry, now of a more tranquil kidney with glass in hand and monocle at ease, having spent the afternoon chuckling over the obituaries in the Times, was in expansive mood, well tanked up, lolling in a cockpit leather armchair. He glanced with difficulty over his shoulder, most of his huge top half stiff with the wallop he'd received from the half-thawed chicken. He was quite alone.
Of course there were troops in the city, thousands of them massing for counterattack. Deaths, head fanatics, the lot of them, heads like peanuts. Brum, 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 Glasgow. Bad news, Jock.
Aye, sir. It's the wee puppy, sir, during the blackout. Jenny came over and the screaming I went on.
Now then, man. Pull yourself to have a piece of special chocolate. And Professor Mailbottom, where's he?
In the laboratory, sir. All night bouncing his balls across the tank.
Damn this leg, my cracky. I'll make Corporal Carpet Chew a choke for this night's doing. Dandan, who put the bounce in the bouncing bomb? Mole Bottom, dear Dandan.
Silent as a smelly one, Hubert entered the room.
Can I play too, Henry? I like taking orders.
Henry exploded with shock.
Don't camarade me, you quizzling. You're not in uniform and it's dark,
roared the Führer of Rawlinson.
But I'm in pyjamas and I'm your brother.
I'm afraid this is going to be an understandable mistake, shouted Henry, blowing strongly on a whistle,
and with a nasty growl, he was over the top. Poor Hubert received a terrific thrashing, plus a crippling kick in the fork, and disgraced, was condemned to his room. To celebrate All Squids Day, there was a face-jumping competition at the Fool and Bladder. This ancient amusement involved leaping onto volunteers' heads, lightly touching, then springing off. To draw blood or squash a nose meant instant disqualification, and this was the skill of it. Seth One-Tooth was unquestioned master of this unusual sport, and he lounged, huge and work-stained, outside the old pub, explaining the rules to Reg Smeaton, newsagent and self-styled encyclopedia. A large, red-faced farm worker with arms like tractors, stripped to the waist, paced out an enormous run-up before turning to thunder down on his grinning partner lying on the green.
He's got no chance, said Seth smugly. Silly buggers wearing spiked running shoes.
Reg Smeaton, Flocko's red wig like a kipper nailed to his bonce, nodded with ill-feigned interest. But the butterfly flexions of his face muscles argued the mental tumult within, urging fervid facts chattering in Stockhausen tongues.
Drawing from my vast, though admittedly unresolved, catalogue of general know-it-all, facts of interest, etc., corroborated, corroboree, a sacred or warlike assembly of aboriginals, may I remind you of the exploits of one William Barker of Manchester? In the 1890s, Billy cleared a canal 35 feet wide, making a running jump, jackknifing into a second to land perfectly dry on the other side.
I could clear a snooker table, full length, mind, from a standing jump before operation, grumbled Seth. I could have made a mint had I been a bit more shrewd.
Did you know that the elephant shrew never closes its eyes?
Through the intestinal smoke of Seth's pipe, Smeaton's sweat-spangled face, eyes straining with mad intensity behind glasses the shape of Ford Cortinas, shuddered with the ungovernable maelstrom of information, inessential, infantry and endless, that constituted the grotesque furniture of his mind. Filing cabinets unlocked, thesauri fell agape. Data danced in strict formation, quick, 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 quick. Puzzles fitted, it all added up, niggling, self-edited, tumbling with clicking impatience, cross-reference and erupting, gathered berserk fierce, heedless and torrential, howling for outlet from his springboard lips. Seth adjusted the strings about his knees, and unnoticed, a passing wood pigeon vacated onto Smeaton's ploughman's koipu burger.
I ain't so nimble now, said Seth, but I used to jump in and out at barrels of eggs without cracking a shell.
I find it